स्वेच्छाकेसरिणः स्वच्छस्वच्छाय आयासित इन्दवः त्रायन्ताम्बो मधुरिपोः प्रपन्नार्तिच्छिदो नखाः. विवक्षा तत्परत्वेन नाङ्गित्वेन कदाचन काले च ग्रहणत्यागौ नाति निर्वहणैषिता निर्व्यूढावपि चाङ्गित्व निर्व्यूढावपि च अङ्गत्वे यत्नेन प्रत्यवेक्षणं रूपकादिरलङ्कारवर्गस्य अङ्गत्वसाधनम्. So he gives, Anandavardhana gives five rules for how alankaras have to be used in such a manner that the rasa abhivyakti, there is no obstruction to the rasa abhivyakti. So we saw examples for each one of those. We saw an example for vivaksha tatparatvena and then kale grahanam, kale tyagaha. Now we have to move on to nati nirvahana ishita. Atyanta nirvahasya iccha yatra na vartate. That is yam alankaram atyantam upayoktum yaha na icchati. So the way the kavi has to use the alankara is such that because he has introduced the alankara, he need not continue with that alankara completely. He can drop it whenever he wants. And he need not use it in its full manner. So there are alankaras like rupaka alankaram, where there are two types of rupaka alankara, which is ekadesha rupakam and purnatvena. So rupaka alankara can exist in all aspects in a shlokam, or it can just be there for one superimposition, or just one simple metaphor on one portion of the shloka can also lend a beauty to it. And just because he has started on that alankara, a kavi need not complete it fully. So rasa nirvahana ekatana hridayaha yam cha na atyantam nirvodham icchati yatha. Rasa nirvahana ekatana hridayaha, rasa nirvahana, one who is in order to carry out the rasa, he is very concentrated in carrying out that rasa, the poet. So rasa nirvahana ekatana hridayaha kavihi yam alankaram atyantam nirvodhum na icchati. The poet should not press too far with the alankara. Example he gives here is from Amarushatakam. Kopat komala lola bahu latika pashena badhva dridham nitva vasa niketanam daitaya sayam sakhinam puraha bhuyo naivamiti स्खलत् कलगिरा संसूच्य दुश्चेष्टितं धन्यो हन्यते धन्यो हन्यत एव निन्नुति परः प्रेयान् रुदत्या हसन्. The scene, the picture here is the Nayika thinks that the Nayika is sure that her Nayaka, her beloved, has cheated on her. So he has maybe some of the marks like danta kshatam chinhani, danta kshata athava naka kshata chinhani santi tasya sharire. So looking at those, she is convinced that he is cheating on her. But it is actually the lover wants to induce that jealousy in her so that, it is another way of a relationship. In a relationship, the Nayaka can try to induce jealousy so that he wants to test her constantly, tease her constantly. So he is actually not cheating on her, but he tries to make those marks maybe with some other, twigs or pushpam or kantakam. All these things he uses and he makes marks on his body. And then he wants to see how much she likes him. He wants to test her utsukata, eagerness to be with him. So he actually, ninnuti paraha, that's why he uses that word. Ninnuti paraha saha preyan, preyan beloved, daitaha. So ninnuti paraha nayakaha, what he does is, he tries to cheat her with this. He actually does not cheat her, but she thinks that he is cheating. So what she does is, she goes and catches him and then brings him to the bedroom. Kopaat, she's very angry here. The Nayika is angry. Sayam, Sayankale, Natu Pratakale. She's been waiting from morning for him to come, but he has not shown his face. The Nayika has not shown his face. She's very upset and she's in viraham. So Sayankale, she does not want to spend the night also alone without him. She decides to go and bring him now. So Sayam, Sayankale, Kopat. She's very angry that he has been away from her. So Kopat, what does she do? Komala Lola Bahu Latika Pashena Dridham Badhva. Badhva. She binds him with her arms, which is like a rope. Komala, soft, Lola, which is dangling. Her arms are so, she doesn't have any strength in her arms and she's in viraham, right? So karshyam. And she probably has not eaten much, so there is no strength in her. And she uses her bahu latika, her arms which are like creepers, and that is a rope. Pashena badva, just like how you will tie someone and then pull him as a punishment, she actually ties him with her arms. So she's actually embracing him. It shows her utsukata here. She wants to be with him, but at the same time, she's also angry. So that is why he puts that Rupaka Alankaram, where he says, Bahu Latika Eva Pashaha. Her arms, which are very soft and creeper-like, is like a rope which has tied him now. Dridham Badva. She ties him really strongly. And then Vasaniketanam Nitva brings him to the bedroom, where they are going to spend the night here. Sakinam Puraha, in front of her friends. So the friends probably have told, so there are two versions. One version is, in Amarajatakam, one of the Vyakhyanam he says is, this is Sakinam Puraha, she wants to prove to them that, he is wrong. Or Lajja Parityaga Dyotakam. She's no longer shy to deal with him. So she is actually a Praudha Naika, Pragalbha Naika. So she can deal with him or have this relationship with him in front of her friends also. So Sakinam Puraha, that is one explanation. But I like the explanation of Lochanakara, where he says, the Sakhi probably would have tried to convince her, saying, he's actually true to you. He has not cheated you. You're unnecessarily assuming things about him. Don't think so badly about him. But she wants to prove to her friends, see, he has made such mistakes. So Sakinam Puraha, in front of her friends, she's saying, Skalat Gira, Skalat Kalakala Gira, Dushcheshtitam Samsuchya Bhuyo Na Evam Iti. Don't do this again. Iti skalat. She's stammering words, but it's very beautiful words that she is saying. Don't do such a thing. If she is really angry, it won't be madhuram. Kalagira. It won't be kala madhuram. It will be really harsh and very tough to hear. But what she's saying is, please don't do this again. No. Iti skalat kalagira. Kim suchya duscheshtitam samsuchya. Pointing out the bad behavior of his, which is maybe the danta nakakshata ityadi samsuchya, pointing out, indicating all those with sweet and stuttering words, she says, don't do this again. Don't do like this. Na evam bhuyaha ma kuru. Tadrishaha preyan dhanyaha ninnutiparaha hasan. Now he is not able to tolerate. He just laughs at her behavior. See, she was so easily cheated by me. I could cheat her and he is not able to control it, so he laughs. Hasan ninnuti paraha, because he knows he is not cheated, but he is actually trying to induce that jealousy in her. So ninnuti paraha saha, he smiles and he is being hit by her. Hanyate rudatya, she cries. She understands. Now, she was angry till now. The moment she sees him laughing, you're only, teasing me like this by this behavior. So she starts crying. Rudatya naikaya hanyate eva. He actually is being hit. Why do you have to do this to me? You needn't have put me through this trouble. Huh? So, Kopat, Komala, Lola, Bahulatika, Pashena Badva, Dridam, Nitva, Vasa, Niketanam, Daitaya, Sayam, Sakinam, Puraha, Bhuyo, Naivamiti, Skalat, Kalagira, Samsuchi, Dushchetitam, Dhanyo, Hanyata. That Nayaka is indeed fortunate because he is being hit by her who is crying. It is why that dhanyatvam means is saying it still she is in love with him. That is why she is going through so much of exercise and you know trying to bring him back to her and all that. So indeed he is fortunate to have such a beloved on his side. So dhanyaha hanyata eva ninnuti paraha preyan rudatya hasan. Atra I wanted to read the Lochanam. See, when we read the Lochanam, we will understand the Rupakam much better. So here we saw that the first line, Bahu Latika Pashena, is your Rupaka Alankara, which he has started off, but he has not continued with it. Na Ati Nirvahanam, he stopped it. So Atrahi Rupakam Akshiptam Anirvyudham cha. Nirvyudham, complete. It is not complete. And Rasapushtaye Param nirvyu anirvyudham, it is not complete because rasa pushtaye, in order to increase that rasa, what he is going to do is, it is samboga paryantam, samboga paryavasai, this is because I told you the key words are sayam. She is eager to be with him. So bahu latika, she has been waiting for him and viraha samsuchaka vakyam, that is bahu latika is a viraha samsuchakam. And then when you look at the word sayam also, she did not do it in the morning. So the indication of sayam means ratri paryantam, what will happen in the night is indicated by the word sayam also. So it is a samboga paryantam paryavasayi, samboga shungara paryavasayi, so it is a rasa pushti only, it happens here. And Bahulatika, let's go with that. So Bahulatika yaha, I'm reading out which is underlined in red here. So Bahulatika yaha, bandhaniya pashatvena rupanam yadi nirvahayet. If you have to extend that rupakam for every other aspect in the shloka, then what do you have to do? The second line, look at the second line where he says, nitva vasa niketanam daitaya sayam sakhinam puraha. Even these have to have that rupakam. Probably daita vyada vaduhu. Like who will use a rope to tie someone? It is the wife of a hunter probably. So you can have a rupakam where daita vyada vaduhu, where instead of using daita, you can use vyada vadu, or the wife of a hunter. And vasagraham, instead of vasagraham, you can superimpose it upon karagara panjaradi iti. If you say like a prison, she brought him, like how a hunter's wife brings the hunter to the prison. If the poet had completed the rupakam, then it would have been anauchityam, param anauchityam syat. That is why he stopped. It is called an ekadesha rupakam. He just stopped with Bahulatika Pasham and moved on to the rest of it so that it will rasa unmukha taya. Because you want the readers to be focused towards the Samboga Shringaram and not towards the Rupaka Alankaram. If we keep on focusing ourselves on the Rupaka Alankaram, it will be Vachyam. It will be, there is no Vengyartha here. Because he has moved away from that, and then he has gone to Vasa Niketanam, Daitaya, Sayam, Sakhinam, Puraha. There is no great Alankara in the rest of the three lines. Only that first one line is, it can also, it actually also adds to the beauty where you say she used her arms like a pasham and tied him to show her utsukata, to show her eagerness to be with him. So it helps in that. But if he had continued with Kara Griham, and if he had said Vyadhavadu, all these would have been anauchityam or improper, because it would have given us an imagery totally different from what we want to understand, what the Kavi wants to show to us. He wants us to think about the Sambhoga Shringaram that might happen after this whole episode. That is where our focus should be. So na ati nirvahana ishita. So sakinam puraha, this is what I said. Bhavatyaha anavaratam bruvate nayam evam karoti iti. You constantly say that this fellow will not do it. Tat pashyantu. See, idanim iti. See, I have caught him red-handed and I have brought him here. So I am telling him bhuyo na evam kuru iti. So that is the importance of sakinam puraha. Skalanti kopavashena kala madhuracha gihi yasyaha sa. So kopavashena, because of anger, she is not able to complete her sentence. It is halfway. Bhuyo na evam ma kuru athava ma evam cheshtaya athava anya naikam prati ma gachha iti. It is not sampurna because of kopa, kopavashat. And skalanti gira means she is stuttering. She is not saying those words in a cogent manner. Kala madhura gira. Even though it is not in a cogent way, it is still very sweet to hear her say that. Atrahi rupakam akshiptam anirvyudham cha param rasapushtaye. So here you find that rupakam, he started off with rupakam, but he did not take it to completion, whereas he just, because the poet had rasa nirvahanam in his mind. He was concentrated on trying to give the rasa to the reader. Okay. Next one is alankarasya nirvahane api pratyavekshanam. Now this is very important. This is actually a very tricky situation where even though he a poet takes the alankara right through the shlokam and he still uses it very carefully. That is only great poets can do that. So he takes an example of Kalidasa's Meghasandesham. Nirvodhum ishtamapi yam yatnat angatvena pratyavekshate. So nirvodhum ishtamapi, even if you want to put the alankara completely, use the alankara to use the alankara in its full maximum possible way in every aspect of the shlokam. Ishtamapi yatnat angatvena pratyavekshate. You should be very careful in putting it as a secondary to the rasam. Yatha shyamaswangam chakitaharini prekshane drishtipatam gandachayam shishini shikhinam barhabhareshu kesham utpashyami pratanashu nadi vichishu bhru vilasan hantaikasmin api na kvachit chandi sadrishyam asti. That is a different reading that I know. This is a very different reading. Hanta ekastham kvachidapi nate bhiru sadrishyam asti. Ityado sa evam upanipadhyamanaha alankaraha rasa abhivyakti hetuhu kavehe bhavati. Okay, let's look at the shlokam. Shyamasu angam. The context we know is Meghasandesham, where the yaksha is separated from his lover and he is giving this sandesham through the megha. So he gives the route to the megha. He says, you will go to Alakapuri and there my wife will be doing one of these things. He lists all the different actions that she might be doing. She might be playing with the mayuram, the peacock that is there, or she might be, and the rerimbo. The doorstep. So she would be putting in flowers, or she would be counting the number of days that are left for me to come back. So she probably would be doing all that. So after saying all that, he says, look for a proper time and then approach her and then give her this message. So one of that message is Shyamasu Anga. See, I'm trying to look for a sadrishyam. See, I'm missing you so much that I kept on looking at each and every object to see if there is any similarity between you and that object, so that I can, vinodayami, atmanam vinodayami, tvat sadrishyam ekaikasmin api napashyami. He ends with that. I'm trying to find a similarity between you and some object so that I can entertain myself. श्यामासु अंगम. हे भीरु, I'll talk about that भीरु later. So when addressing her, he says, you're a भीरु, very cowardly person, or you don't have a धैर्यम, you don't have a courage. श्यामासु अंगम, श्यामासु ते अंगम उत्पश्यामि, उत्पश्यामि यत्नात् यत्नेन प्रेक्षितुम् और प्रेक्षितुम् यते. I'm trying to look for a similarity in the creeper. Shyama is a priyangulata, it's a creeper which is supposed to be very soft and beautiful to look at. So I thought maybe I can see a similarity between your shariram and that creeper. Shyamasu, in the creeper, I was trying to look for your angam. Chakita harini prekshane tava drishtipatam. Chakita harini, the marunda maan vidigal. ஒரு ஒரு பயந்த கண்களும் யூனோ டியர் ஃபீமேல் டியர் விச் இஸ் வெரி சகிதம் ஆர் அஃப்ரேட் ஸோ வென் இட் கீப்ஸ் மூவிங் இட்ஸ் ஐஸ் திஸ் வே அண்ட் தட் வே ஸோ ஐ எம் ட்ரைங் டு லுக் ஃபார் யோர் ஐசைட் இன் த ஃபீமேல் டியர்ஸ் ஐ ஆர் த வே இட் லுக்ஸ் சஷினி கண்டச்சாயாம் சஷினி in the moon, which is also very pale in color, I'm trying to see if it matches your ganda. Kapola chaya, kapola kantim shashini prekshitum yate. I'm trying to see if it is there in the moon. Shikinam barhavareshu tava keshan utpashyami. I'm trying to see your keshapasham in the feathers of peacock feathers. அந்த மயிலோட தோகை இருக்கு இல்லையா. சோ ஐ அம் ட்ரைங் டு லுக் ஃபார் தட். பிரதனுஷு நதி வீச்சிஷு தவ ப்ரூ விலாசானு உத்பஷ்யாமி. தேர் இஸ் அ ரிவர் ஃப்ளோயிங் ஹியர் அண்ட் தேர் ஆர் ஸ்மால் ஸ்மால் பிரதனுஷு. இஃப் தேர் ஆர் பிக் வேவ்ஸ் தென் ஐ கான்ட் ஃபைண்ட் யுவர் ப்ரூ விலாசம். ப்ரூ விலாசம் இஸ் ஹர் ஐப்ரோ, த டான்சிங் ஆஃப் தி ஐப்ரோஸ் விச் இஸ் வெரி சட்டில். The subtle actions that you make with your eyebrows, I'm trying to find them in the small, small pratanushu. Prakarshena tanu. Tanu itself means small waves. Here, pratanushu means very small fluttering of waves that are there. I'm trying to find your bru vilasa. Pratanushu nadi vichishu bru vilasanu utpashyami hanta. Now, see, in all this, if you find, as you are looking at it, you have upama based utpreksha. I'm trying to find your angam in something. You cannot find shariram in the creeper. You cannot find a lady's drishti in a harini prekshita. But there is an utpreksha there, which is based on the similarity. Upamana upameya aropena tatra utpreksha alankaraha asti in the three lines. Now what he does is hanta. ஏகஸ்தம் க்வசிதபி சாத்ருஷ்யம் ந அஸ்தி. ஐ கான்ட் ஃபைண்ட் ஈவன் ஒன் பிட் ஆஃப் ஈவன் ஒன். சி, எவ்ரி திங் நீட் நாட் பி பிரசன்ட் இன் ஒன் ஃபார்ம். ஈச் ஐ எம் அட்லீஸ்ட் ஒன்லி ட்ரைங் டு லுக் ஃபார் ஒன் பார்ட் ஆஃப் யூ இன் ஒன் ஆப்ஜெக்ட். ஐ எம் நாட் எக்ஸ்பெக்டிங் அன் ஆப்ஜெக்ட் டு பி கம்ப்ளீட்லி சிமிலர் டு யூ ஸோ தட் ஐ கேன் என்டர்டெயின் மை செல்ஃப். I'm only looking for one small aspect of you. Just drishti patam, natu sampurna nayanam. Drishti patam eva drishtum angam. He's not even mentioning, you know, atmanam or you, tvam, tvam prekshitum. He doesn't, I know the creeper cannot bring out the essence of you. It can only resemble your angam, only maybe your limbs, that's all. Only one aspect of you can the creeper try to emulate. But even that I'm not able to see. Drishti patam, ganda chaya, natu ganda, sampurna gandam, kapola, kapolasya kanti leshaha chandre astiva nava iti pashyam. Shikinam varha bhareshu keshanu, natu alakam atava kesham. Only one aspect, bru vilasam only I'm trying to find out. I can't find the whole, you know, the range of actions that you can perform with your eyebrows. I can't find all those, that the idea behind it or the sentient nature that is there in your actions. I can't find, I know. That is why he's saying, hanta. ekastham, all of these cannot be present in one place. So at least one aspect, I'm trying to find a similarity. Sadrishyam kvachidapi nasti. It's not at all present. So that way, you can understand that Vipralambha. He feels so dejected and cheated by that. So he feels so sad to be away from her, and he's not able to enjoy her presence even in an inanimate object. So Hanta ekasminnapi, there is a difference between Bhiru and Chandi. Some readings have Chandi. Chandi can mean, you know, kopa yukta, so which means you are so angry that you don't want to share your aspects with any of these. I don't know how that will fit, but for Bhiru, Dhanyalokakara beautifully he says, see, where is that? Bhiru, yaha hi katara hridayaha bhavati na asau sarvasvam ekastham dharayati. See, hey Bhiru, you are very afraid that if I see all of your aspects in something here, if you had put all of your aspects here, then maybe, I'm trying to understand how that can. Because if you are very afraid, then you won't keep all your wealth in one place, right? These are all like her wealth. So she is very afraid to keep her wealth in one place. That's what he is trying to say here. Sometimes I feel Chandi itself is better. Okay. If you don't understand, leave it, because I myself am a little bit confused about why he uses Bhiru. The idea here is utpreksha, atrahi utprekshayaha tadbhava adhyaropa rupayaha anupranakam sadrishyam yatha upakrantam tatha nirvahitam api. See, he started off with shyamasu angam chakita harini prekshane drishtipataha utpashyami. The same way he continued after that, Pratanushunadi Vichishu Bruvilasam. He continued and ended it completely. Nirvahitamapi Vipralambarasa Poshakameva Jatam Hanta Ekasthamapi Kvachite Nadrishyate Sadrishyam Nadrishyate. I can't find the similarity. He starts off with the similarity and he completes it fully. He finishes that sentence completely with the utpreksha, which is got upama as a base, but ultimately it is only highlighting the Vipralambha Shringaram there. Okay, so shyama swangam chakita harini ityadau sa evam upanibadhyamanaha alankaraha evam upanibadhyamanaha. If you have to use the alankara, there can exist shlokas where alankara need not even be present, or there need not be a great alankara. The moment you read the shlokam, it does not mean that you will understand what alankaram there is, right? So it doesn't matter. But if you are using, if the kavi is using an alankara, it has to be used in such a manner. Rasa abhivyakti hetuhu kavehe bhavati alankaraha evam upanibadhyamanaha alankaraha eva. Only if you use these five rules, kale tyagaha, kale grahanam, napi nirvahana ishita, vivaksha tatparatvena, and nirvahane api pratyavekshana. All these five rules should be adhered to so that the rasa abhivyakti happens. Ukta prakara atikrame. If on the other hand, the poet does not follow these five rules, ukta prakraya prakara atikrametu niyamenaiva rasabhanga hetuhu sampadyate. Definitely there will be a rasabhanga. The rasa he will not be The rasam is not treated to its fullest and it won't be enjoyed by the audience. So lakshyam cha tathavidam mahakavi prabandheshu api drishyate bahushah. So lakshyam, tathavidam lakshyam, tathavidam, siyukta prakara atikrame niyamena rasabanga hetuhu sampadyate. There will be a rasabangatvam there. And tathavidam lakshyam ityukte rasabanga lakshyam kavyam mahakavi prabandeshu api drishyate. We find a lot of poetry written by mahakavis also where there is a rasabangatvam, where they have used alankara too much and there is no focus on the rasa. Tattu, but that one, sukti, why didn't you give examples? See, in Auchitya Vicharam, we saw how he gave udaharanam and then a pratyudaharanam. One udaharanam and then a pratyudaharanam. Anandavardhana does not want to give any pratyudaharanam. Tat tu pratyudaharanam. Sukti sahasra dyotita atmanam mahatmanam dosha udghoshanam atmanaha eva dushanam bhavati iti na vibhajya darshita. It is only a dushanam for me. No, atmanaha eva dushanam. Because I am trying to dosha udghoshanam. I am trying to portray the dosha of great poets who have written sukti sahasra dyotita atmanam. They have tried to suggest, use dhvani in thousands of shlokas. There may be one or two which have dosham. Why should I highlight those? And it, no, it's like ego hi dosho gunasan nipate nivajjati indo kiraneshvavankaha. One dosham will completely merge with the thousands of beautiful shloka that the Mahakavi has written. So we should be like, no, Anandavardhana takes the stance of, what is it? Guna dosho budho grindhan indukshvedavi veshwaraha param kantheni yachati shirasa shlaghate purvam param kantheni yachati guna dosho budho grindhan. Budha scholar should take, he looks at a poetry, he will understand both the gunam and dosham. But what should he do? Indukshvedavi veshwaraha, just like how Shiva during the Samudra Mathanam, he saw both the Indu, Chandra, Moon, and Kshveda, Visham. He looked at both. And what did he do? Shirasa shlaghate purvam. He praised the Chandra by giving it a position as high as his upon his head and kept the Visham in his kantha. That is, he did not let it come out and torture others. So he kept it within himself. So dosham kantastameva karaniyam. You should not bring it to the mouth or speech. So dosha udghoshanam atmanaha eva doshanam bhavati iti na vibhajya darshitam. So I have not given any pratyudaharanam for all of these things. Kintu rupakadehe alankara vargasya ya iyam vyanjagatve rasadi vishaye lakshana dirdarshita tam anusaran स्वयं च अन्यत् लक्षणम् उत्प्रेक्षमाणः यदि अलक्षिक्रम प्रतिभम् अनन्तरोक्तम् एनं ध्वनेः आत्मानम् उपनिबध्नाति सुकविः समाहितचेताः तदा तस्य आत्मलाभः भविष्यति भवति महीयान् इति. सो इन् अदर् वर्ड्स् यूसिङ्ग् द रूपकालङ्कार एक्सेट्रा इन् सच् अ मेनर् एस् अ व्यञ्जक. As a suggestor, if he uses the entire set of alankaras, arthalankara, rasadi vishaye lakshana digdarshita, I have shown a small aspect of how the alankaras can be used as a vyanjaka for rasam. Tam anusaran, by using that path, swayam anyat lakshanam utprekshamana, either he looks at, for either a kavi can use these rules for writing a poetry himself, or he can use it as a judgment for others. Anyat lakshanam utprekshamanaha yadi alakshyakrama pratibham anantaroktam enam dhvanehe. Alakshyakrama pratibham anantaroktam enam dhvanehe atmanam upanibadnati. If the sukavi, a poet who is samahita chetaha, who is concentrated and he is focused on the rasa, he is able to understand other definitions also, and these rules also he follows, and he is able to use that dvaneh atmanam upanibadhnati. That dvani atma is alakshakrama pratibam. Alakshakrama pratibam is your asamlakshakrama vyangya or the rasadvani, which is the dvani atma. That he has to use in a kavya. In the sense, he has to write a kavya which is dvani param or which is rasadvani param, and he should not focus too much on the alankara. Even if he focuses on the alankara, he should use it in such a manner as to fall within these rules. Tasya. So what will happen for a kavi who does this? Tada. At that point of time, tasya kavehe atmalabaha bhavati. Mahiyan atmalabaha bhavati. He will attain a great, it is a gain for him, not for anything else. Now, he moves on. We saw asamlakshikramadhvani, which is rasadhvani. Now he is giving the samlakshikramavyangasya different types. Samlakshikramam means samyak kramaha lakshyate, where samyak lakshyate kramaha. Yes, yeah. So the process is very clearly seen in samlakshikramavyangya. Either it is through shabda or the artham meaning, or it can be both. So shabda shakti moolaha, artha shakti moolaha, ubhaya shakti moola is a category which is accepted in Kavya Prakasham, whereas which is a later text, it's the 11th century text, this is a 9th century text. So here, or 10th century, 9th century. So here he accepts only two varieties, which is shabda shakti moola and artha shakti moola. Another great big difference between Kavya Prakasham and Dvanyalokakara is he does not, Dvanyalokakara, Anandavardhana does not accept Vastuna Vastu Dvani in Shabda Shakti Moola. For him, Shabda Shakti Moola Dvani is only Vastuna Alankara Dvani. There is no Vastuna Vastu Dvani at all. Be clear about it, but that is there in Kavya Prakasha. So, Kramena Pratibhatyatma Yo Asya Anuswana Sannibhaha Shabdartha Shakti Moola Tvatu Sopi Dvedha Vyavastitaha. So api this asya vivakshita anya paravachyasya dvanehe samlakshya krama vyangyatvat, that is its process is clearly seen, hence anuranana prakyaha. Anuranana is like an echoing. So when you gantadi shabda anantaram jayamanaha pratishabdaha anuranana rupaha athava anuswana rupaha. Anuswana sannibaha means where the echoing never happens at the same time when the original sound is there. So you hear, you first produce the original sound, and then the echo, or when there is a ringing, a pratishabdam that comes after, always comes after. So it does not come along with this. So that is why when you read the Vachyartha, that vachaka shabda or the vachyartha may give rise to, will give, if it give rise, gives rise to another meaning or alankaram, because meaning means artha, vastuna vastu is there in artha shakti muladvani, whereas in shabda shakti muladvani it is vastuna alankara. So either the meaning vachyartha gives rise to a alankara, or vachaka shabda gives rise to an alankara, or the vachyartha gives rise to another vastu, then it is a it is called a samlakshikrama vyangyaha. So api shabda shaktya prakashat, where is it, sorry, asya vivakshita anyapara vachyasya dvanehe samlakshikrama vyangyatvat anuranana prakyaha yaha atma, so api yaha atma dvanihi, so api shabda shakti moolaha artha shakti moolaha cha iti dviprakarakaha. There are two types of it. Now the next one, a confusion may arise as to why he says that vastuna vastu is not shabda shakti, because that is where he brings in the differentiation between shlesha and shabda shakti. So the rupam of it is such that only an alankara can be suggested. ननु शब्दशक्त्या यत्र अर्थान्तरं प्रकाशते स यदि ध्वनेः प्रकारः उच्यते तदिदानीं श्लेषस्य विषयः एव अपहृतः इति अपहृतः स्यात् दट् इस् युवर् पूर्वपक्षि सिद्धान्ति इस् न अपहृतः इति आह सो द कारिका इस् अ प्रूफ् ऐ विल् स्टाप् वित् द पूर्वपक्षि एण्ड् देन् गो टु द सिद्धान्ति नेक्स्ट् क्लास् सो ननु the purvapakshi starts off shabdashaktya if you say that by the force of a word another meaning is suggested so by the force of the word means there are so many places where slesha can apply where there are double meaning and both meanings if one meaning if one by the, it is only by the force of the word when we saw prithukartha swara patram in kavya prakasham there were so many shlokas that we saw we are going to look at yena dvasta manobhavena also सो शब्दस्य शक्त्या एव यत्र अर्थान्तरं प्रकाशते स यदि ध्वनेः प्रकारः उच्यते इफ् यु से दट् दट् इस् आल्सो अनदर् आस्पेक्ट् आफ् ध्वनि देन् श्लेषस्य विषयः एव अपकृतः देन् देर् इस् नो स्कोप् फार् श्लेष अट् आल् बिकास् श्लेष आल्सो देर् इस् डबल् मीनिङ्ग् इट् इस् ओन्ली बै द फोर्स् आफ् द वर्ड् द वर्ड् गिव्स् रैस् टु अनदर् मीनिङ्ग् then there is no context there is no scope for slesha iti chet na apakritah ityah so no the difference main difference between slesha and shabda shakti is as far as ananda vardhana goes it is extremely clear it is only when we go to kavya prakasham that we have this doubt of how does vastuna vastu cannot be considered as dhvani So there is something called prakrita and aprakrita slesham. In slesha alankara, there are two meanings that come out. Let's take one shloka where there are two meanings. Due to the context, you can fix one meaning to the context. The other meaning can also fit the context, right? Then it is a slesha because both are vachyartham. There is no vengyam there. There is no such thing as, for me, I feel this is what the meaning should be. I feel this is what I, this is the meaning that I get. Now the poet has intended, specifically intended those words to give rise to two meanings and both are vachyam. They are primary because the poet wants you to understand both meaning, which is prakritam, which is applies to the context. If it is aprakritam, if both are aprakritam, then by way of similarity, you can connect both of those to the prakritam. Even there, it is slesha. When there is a prakritam and aprakritam, you have a context and in that context, you are fixing the meaning. Say, for example, vahini is a word that indicates both river and army. I think you read in Prataparudriyam, vahini is a river and that or it is also an army when you are describing a king you don't need to describe the river you are talking about his army so the context fixes the meaning and says that the vahini means river and the entire sorry vahini means army and the entire shloka applies to the army of the king but because of the force of the word I also get the meaning of a river that there are two matams one accept it as slesha and they say that this is only two meanings are the poet can could have used chamuhu instead of vahini but he has used vahini specifically to indicate that it is he wants to give both meanings and so it is prakrita and aprakrita slesha vahini the river does not apply to the context so it is an aprakrita artha in that case it is a prakrita aprakrita slesham that is a type of alankara that is one set of people who agree the other set of people are who say you know if there is an aprakrita meaning there is a prakrita meaning the dhvani is actually a comparison between the two which is upama I'm comparing the army the different branches of the army to the different rivers shushube vahini patihi that is the I think that's the example in Kuvalayanandam. Shushubhe Vahini Patihi. The ocean Vahini Patihi. And Vahini Patihi in the context of army is a commander of the army. So if one meaning is Prakritam and the other meaning is Aprakritam, the Aprakritam meaning is actually lends to Upama Alankara Dhvani. So Vastuna Alankara Dhvani, and it is a Shabda Shakti. It is by the force of the word Vahini that we get the meaning. We get the Vyangyartha. So these are two different matam. Wherever you find shlokas which are Slesha, it is difficult to distinguish between Shabda Shakti Muladhvani and Slesha. But if we follow Anandavardhana, it is very easy. Vastuna Alankaradhvani is only Shabda Shakti Muladhvani, but the Vastuna Vastudhvani is a little bit tough to understand. Some of the examples in Kavya Prakasham are better. So we will go with this Karika next class.